in its preparation for the general election, which is 11 days away. The Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission had a date with the election observers from within and outside the country to address different concerns over the electoral process. The issue of presidential result periodic announcements dominating the sitting, with IBC saying its decision to avoid the regular results was not final.
If the Kenyans feel that that has to be done, the commission will look at the issue, because it was a plenary decision, and we can look at the issue and see if that needs to be, that repetition has to be done, then we may have no problem doing it.
We expect to do a public demo again, Prof, I think on 31st. Is on 31st confirmed? On 31st, transmitting from the 47 counties, so that we see how now it hits the screen here and all the tallying centers.
IBC said Kenyans will get regular updates through the media and a public accessible portal.
The same results will be placed in a publicly accessible web portal. So you can even sit from the comfort of your house or your office, download these results forms, and do your own tallying, even in your own houses, if you want.
The electoral body further said its personnel will move to the polling stations a week before the polls.
7 days before elections, we should be able to move into the polling stations, secure them, and also the registers will be published and pinned on every polling station door 7 days before the election day.
In as far as prison is concerned, IEBC is going to facilitate those observers who want to go to the prisons.
IBC says in case there was total shutdown of the internet during the result transmission, it will revert to the manual system.
We should be able to still transmit results even if there's some mischief of internet being shut down. So that will not hamper our activities. But in the event that in the worst case scenario, we shall still have the forms which will have been signed at the polling stations and at constituency level, and those will be available. So at any given time, in whatever scenario, the commission should be able to announce results to the country.
IBC Electoral Code of Conduct Enforcement Committee has in the meantime summoned Marsabit Governor Ukur Yatani and area Jubilee gubernatorial candidate Mohammed Ali over political chaos witnessed in Marsabit town on Wednesday. The two will appear before the committee Friday for grilling over the violence that left several people injured, among them police officers. Samson Kitavi, Channel One News.